Chicago, Illinois, a tough city whose inner neighborhoods struggle with violence, cold winters, and poverty. But the glue that always holds this city together is the game of basketball. This is the story of Rico Hill, who made it out of one of the city's toughest neighborhoods.
Hello, my name is Rico Hill. I come from the south side of Chicago, 119th and Loomis to be exact, right across the street from the Croc Center. I learned the game of basketball in that neighborhood playing at Cooper Park and playing for the great Mr. Gary Adams, who coached at Whistler for over 30 years. And our park basketball was life. And if you wasn't gonna get out there and gladiate, you didn't even get on that court. My seventh and eighth grade year playing at Whistler, we won the district championship. Was in there recruited to go to Brother Rice. Brother Rice really helped cultivate me into the player that I wanted to be, teaching me a lot of things fundamentally that I might not have already knew. Especially worked on my jump shot, my ball handling, my reading and setting screens, and defensive principles. I played for, he should be a future Hall of Famer in the IHSA, Coach Pat Richardson. My senior year was the Tony Lawless Catholic League Player of the Year Award, the first person in Brother Rice to ever get it, and I was also inducted into that Hall of Fame. My high school exploits led me to a scholarship to Illinois State University. Illinois State was probably one of the smallest schools that recruited me, but it was the first school I ever got a letter from for basketball. And for me, that was just always big. I think that meant a lot to me when it came finally time to make my decision. My first choice was DePaul, because DePaul was always my dream school and to play for Joey Meyer. But they went on probation my senior year in high school, and I wouldn't have been able to play in the NCAA tournament until I was a senior. I mean, I really wanted to go somewhere where I knew people wanted me. Well, I knew they wasn't gonna over-recruit like they do with some of the bigger schools in the country, who tell you everything you wanna hear until they get you, and then next year they're trying to get somebody who they think better. I actually started early in my career. The first game of the year, my starting power forward got hurt, and I started the second game of my college career and had a double-double at 14 and 10 points against LaSalle University. Never forget that moment. And then later on, once we started conference play in January, I was a permanent starter for the remainder of the season. And my freshman year, we qualified for the NIT. We went to the third round, and I was our leading scorer and rebounder in the NIT as a freshman. My sophomore year, when we came back, we became a real, really good team and started to gain national attention. We got as high as like 31 in the rankings. Getting votes for the top 25 for the first time in a long time at ISU. We made the NCAA tournament. I was runner-up for Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year, and I got the conference tournament MVP by scoring 81 points in three games and helping us capture an automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. My junior year was really like almost like a fairy tale year, where we started the year ranked 16th in Sports Illustrated. We had national recognition. I had cover story articles with Slam for Rico Suave. And really started to live that life that you always dreamed of when you first picked up a basketball and laced your shoes up. I ended up leaving school after the NBA draft. But I ended up going out to the NBA Summer League and having a great Summer League and signing with a team in ACB in Spain called Fuenlabrada. We ended up finishing fourth that year in the ACB League. We went back to Spain and played for Estudiantes in the Euro League, where we did really well, and I actually played really well. The best year, I think, of my professional career came my third season in France, where I was MVP of the Pro A France LNB for Le Mans, and our team finished second in the country that year. From that point, I started to really travel. I went to Italy, A1 the next year for Pallacanestro Messina. The following year, I think I went back to France for Dijon. Then it was to the Philippines, Portugal, even back to Spain one more time in Sabadell. But it's been a remarkable journey. I mean, along the way, making great friends that's all over the world that feel like family, learning how to speak three languages just because you live there and you wanted to be able to understand and adapt to the culture and really fit in and not just be there existing. There's so much that I think I've gained from just playing basketball that I would have never experienced if I hadn't had this opportunity.